Dr. Jason Saunders here with HBOT USA and another 3-minute research review. Today we're going to talk about hyperbaric oxygen as it relates to post-stroke care and recovery. So we have two studies here to go over. The first one was a hyperbaric oxygen induces late neuroplasticity in post-stroke patients. So can we actually have neurologic changes? Can we have healing? Is the brain plastic? In other words, can it remodel, can it remold, and can it heal even many months past a stroke? The other one is improvement, specifically of improvement of memory impairments in post-stroke patients as a result of hyperbaric oxygen. So the first one's really looking at brain function and healing, and the other one is a symptom of post-stroke, which is typically memory loss following the stroke. So in the late neuroplasticity stroke group, we had 74 patients. They all had to have had a stroke either anywhere from 6 months at the minimum up to 3 years. And it could have either been a ischemic stroke or a hemorrhagic stroke. And there was two groups, obviously a treated group and a non-treated group. The brain activity was assessed through SPECT imaging, as well as an ADL and quality of life index that was used to evaluate changes in their overall function and life quality. Neurologic functions and quality of life both significantly improved following hyperbaric oxygen sessions, and no improvement of that nature was found in the control group. The SPECT imaging also showed correlated improvements with the similar areas of the brain associated with whatever their functional losses were. And that was also confirmed with CT scan in terms of anatomic healing as well as vascular and metabolic healing. In the specifically memory study, improvement in memory impairment in post-stroke patients by hyperbaric oxygen, the goal was to address a very common impairment, which was memory loss. It was conducted on 91 stroke patients, 18 years or older, again, also ischemic or hemorrhagic stroke. The stroke had to be a minimum of 3 months up to 180 months prior to the initiation of hyperbaric oxygen. In both studies, I didn't say this in the last one, both studies were also 5 days a week of sessions, 100% oxygen, 90 minutes each session, 2 atmospheres of pressure. And we did memory testing pre and post. The assessments were done only at the beginning of the clinical trial and then at the end of the clinical trial. The results showed statistically significant improvement in all measures of memory after hyperbaric oxygen, as well as a correlated improvement in brain metabolism, also seen through SPECT scan imaging. Although further research is needed, the results illustrate a high potential for hyperbaric oxygen for improving memory impairments in post-stroke patients, even years after the acute insult. And so the point here is this: hyperbaric oxygen is delivering higher than typical oxygen levels, and that oxygen has the capacity to get into places that normal oxygen that you and I are breathing right now can't get to. It creates increased blood oxygen levels. It creates neovascularization, which is literally new blood vessel growth, so that damaged blood vessels that can't carry oxygen can regrow new routes to that damaged area, thereby getting the oxygen to the damaged centers. It also creates stem cell release and neuroplasticity. And so if we can get oxygen, stem cells, and neuroplasticity to all come together at the same time, we can absolutely show improvement in memory, improvement in motor skills, improvement in central nervous system reflexes. A lot of these post-stroke impairments that people are often left with years and years following their stroke can absolutely still heal with the proper treatment. And so hyperbaric oxygen is one of those things that, if implemented even well after the initial injury, can still show promise and improvement in quality of life.